that we used to play in childhood. We used to find that in our Nokia phone. So we had emulated that game. This game has been prepared by Shamu Bhattacharya, Rishabh Thakkar, and myself, Sandeep Rao. Here we first declare the header files required for the code. After the header files, there are certain Linux libraries that we need to declare because our program is been running Linux. After that, we are setting up some variables. We are setting up some variables for the consoles. So here, off arrow has been assigned to A, left arrow has been assigned to B, right arrow has been assigned to C, and down arrow has been assigned to D. And the enter key that is used for beginning the game has been assigned to 10. Then we are assigning the body and the basic structures of the snake. So asterisk, asterisk sign has been used for the snake head, star has been used for the body of the snake. Straight line has been used for walls, and for ceiling we are using a high hand sign. The food has been assigned as X, and the rest of the array in which the snake moves has been assigned to as blank. Then in this part we are assigning some Linux functions that have some similarities with Monaro header file in Windows. For that we are setting up some functions here. So these functions are being set up for the Linux machine to run the code. After that, the next codes are being similar for both Windows and Linux files. So the next controls of the game starts. First, we need to check what the user input. So in press, if a user press escape, then it will quit from the game. If the user presses P, that means the game will pause. Or else the game will start automatically. After that, in this particular code, we have assigned the speed of the snake. We can change the speed at the service. We have given this speed 4, so the snake will move at speed of 4. If we decrease this, if we give this speed as 1, then the speed will move much lower. If we increase the value, then the speed of the snake will increase. After that, we have assigned in this particular code, we have assigned the movement of the snake, right? Pressing which key the snake will move. Then for the upward arrow key, the snake will move upwards. Downward arrow key, the snake will move upwards. Rightward arrow key, the snake will move rightwards. And the leftward arrow key, the snake will move. So these are the directions. Now the attributes of the snake, like how it will move. This is the snake which is moving with speed 4, and this is the food that is assigned with X, as you see here, and these are the walls. Okay. So the attribute of the game, like how it will eat the food and how the walls are made and how the body of the snake will increase, will be explained by the efficiency.
That if the snake collides with the wall, the game ends. As the snake collides with the wall, so it loses. And when the snake had the food, the tail of the body increases. Here, in this, we have to create an array where once the snake moves ahead, the tail of the tail is removed and the head is added in the forward direction. Similarly, the snake is having the food, the tail increases, and this at the red sign, this denotes the head of the snake. Then, here we have used the rank function, which is used to create a random food where it is allocated inside this frame. And the snake is added. And as we press the buttons, the arrowhead, which is if we press upward, it moves upside. When we press downward, it moves downward. Then when we press the left arrow, it goes to the left direction. And we go when press right, it moves down, like we can see. So while the snake is moving, there are certain things we have to take into account. The first thing is that the size of the snake remains constant while it is not eating the food. So in this case, as my friend has explained, that while the head increases by 1 unit, the tail has been reduced by 1 unit. So in this array, the other things are blank, and these three are denoted as stars. So one star is being replaced by a blank every time the snake moves forward. In this case, while eating the food and creating the food, there are certain things we have to keep in mind, that the food doesn't land on the snake. So if the food lands on the snake, the game would come to an error. It would show a bug. So in that case, we have to make sure that the snake doesn't interlap with the food. So we check that the array positions of the snake, while the random position of the food is being created, that the random position does not collide with the array position of the snake. In this case, as the snake eats the food, the head is generated. Now the question stands before us, that in which direction the head would generate, because the snake has both parts. So as we are extending the head of the snake to the star, there would be two positions in where the head can be placed. To come up with a solution for this problem, we denote the direction in which the snake moves. So if the snake moves in this direction, the rightward direction, we assign a head to the right side of the snake. If the snake moves upward, in the upward direction, we assign a head to the upward direction of the snake. In this way, the snake is being created. Now, here it is the game over screen. It is an order screen. So, suppose the snake has hit its own tail, or the snake hits the boundary, whichever comes first. In that case, it would show a game over screen, and the game would terminate from its position. This was our game.
Very good.